So today we are going to see what are the advantages and disadvantages of a home kitchen compared to a restaurant. So a home kitchen is any kind of food business you start from home, where you can cook food from home and serve to your contacts, to your masses or to your peripheral areas. Now this was, home kitchen was not possible around 15-20 years back, because ordering from home itself was a very, very new thing. So for all the, first of all, let me tell you who I am. My name is Gopal Kamath. I'm the founder of Get Your Restaurant. I'm a hotelier and a restauranter. And my mission is to teach people how to start their own food businesses. And one of my favorite concepts in the food business is a home kitchen. I'm very fond of this concept. And the only reason is that it is very, very easy to start a home kitchen with as less investment as possible, without any huge experience or working knowledge, and with as fast as you can. So let's get into the details. Firstly, a home kitchen is very, very less capital intensive. What I mean by that is, you don't require lakhs of rupees to start a home kitchen. You can hardly spend 5 or 10,000 rupees and start a home kitchen, compared to a restaurant where you have to pay the deposit, you have to pay the rent, you have to do the capital investment, kitchen, the interiors, and everything has to be done. So it is pretty high capital intensive. Second point is that you can start a home kitchen within 15 to 30 days. It might even not take you that. You can even literally start a home kitchen within 5 to 10 days, compared to a restaurant where you require at least 2 to 3 months, because you will take the place, you will sign the agreement, you will have to do a little bit of civil work, then you will have to get the licenses, then you will have to do the electrical work, the kitchen equipment, this gas, and everything needs to be done. So it will take you around 2 to 3 months to start a restaurant. Now the third point is, you require few licenses for a home kitchen. Hardly just an FSSAI license is more than enough for a home kitchen, compared to a restaurant where you require too many licenses. Because it's a commercial outlet, you require fire NOC, you require a Gumasta license, you require FSSAI license, food safety license, you require maybe if it's a lounge, you require a police NOC also. So there are a lot of licenses which are required in a typical type of restaurant or a cloud kitchen or any kind of other commercial outlet compared to a home kitchen. The fourth is, and I mean, it is not that home kitchen has all the advantages compared to a restaurant. There are a few disadvantages also, which I would like to cover. So the main disadvantage is that a home kitchen is less scalable. What I mean by less scalable is, so let's say for example, you've started a home kitchen and you start doing very well. There is a certain glass ceiling which you will hit as far as sales are concerned. You cannot go beyond that, because the capacity of a kitchen in a home is pretty small. So you will not be able to do business beyond 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh rupees, compared to a restaurant where you can take it to literally tens of lakh rupees, 10 lakh, 15 lakh, 20 lakh rupees. Because the kitchen is bigger, you can stuff in more people to work and you can remove more production, compared to a home kitchen where, you know, there are a little bit of disadvantages as spacing is concerned, as well as working is concerned. You have your relatives with you, you have your son, daughter, husband, wife, whoever. So, you know, then day-to-day life will also get a little bit of turmoil once you increase your production. Now, leaving that aside, another advantage is that you require less staff to start a home kitchen. You don't require a bigger quantity of staff compared to a restaurant. A restaurant, since it is big, it is covering more number of people, it will require bigger staff. And that brings me to the last point, which is low cost of operations. So in a home kitchen, you don't require to pay rent, you don't require to pay deposit. It's your own house and you're starting to cook food, compared to a restaurant where the cost is pretty high, because you have to pay everything commercial, including electricity, gas. So I would clearly tell you that if you want to start a food business, if you are clueless where to start a food business, first of all, let me tell you, I am doing a 21-day live workshop next month from 1st of December to 21st of December. If you are interested to learn how to start a home kitchen step by step, join, click the link in the description section and join right away. It is a paid workshop, it is not a free workshop, but I am taking you step by step for all the 21 days on how to start a home kitchen. Now, a home kitchen should be the first concept of any person who is planning to dive into the food business world. The reason is, this helps you, home kitchen helps you to know your speciality. It helps you to test whether this business is for you or no. And thirdly, this home kitchen will really prove, or rather really help you to understand that whether you want to really expand to a bigger commercial outlet or no. So think of this home kitchen as a when you are learning on somebody else's car and without any investment, and you are planning to learn, you know, motor driving. When you're doing it, you join a motor training vehicle company course and all. So that's what is home kitchen. It's basically testing out the market. And a lot of people do it themselves continuously also. So it's not that it is, you cannot, you just have to test it. Lot of students in my coaching program are earning more than 50,000 rupees or a lakh rupees from home doing a home kitchen. So join the 21-day workshop if you are really interested to start your own home kitchen, and see you in the next video. If you have liked this video, please subscribe to this channel. This channel has got everything, this channel or this page, wherever you are seeing this, this has got everything related to food business, because I am a hotelier and a restauranter and I don't know anything else, I just know about food. So share this with your friends so that they could also get some help if they want to start a food business of their own. Like this video, share it, subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.